if you remember from the last episode, we talked about releasing, right? The timidity, releasing some of the feelings and the fears that we have. Today, we're going to talk about how do we release the bad vibes, because we all have them, right? We all have them. Now, here's the thing. Sometimes with our, what do we call it? Our spiritual wokeness. Those of you who are woke out there, we do all this personal work and development. Yeah, we do this spiritual seeking to bring our own healing. And we all have triggers. So there are times when you're going about your life. See, I'm already getting choked up about it. You go through your life and you have these triggers in the shadow. Let's just call it like that, right? Like you're living your life and you're fine and everything's good. But underneath the shadows of things, there are some bad vibes that are hanging out. If you watched my previous show, Marketing for the Rest of Us, there were a couple episodes I did on anger. What I saw this past summer was that for 20 years, I've used the energy of anger to produce results. That wasn't like I was walking around every day kicking things and, you know, screaming and yelling. When I was younger, in my 20s, when I got into business, what I noticed, I was the kind of guy that had lots of energy, really big faith for things. That approach quickly depleted my savings, right? Like I was like, I don't know how I'm going to do it. We'll figure it out. It'll be okay. And then I blew through my savings and I wasn't quite sure how to go build the business. And it was in that, I think I started to make some judgments about myself. Like I'm naive. I don't really know what I'm doing. And I, you know, I'm the kind of guy that doesn't like structure. So I was like bouncing all around and there was, I can see it now in hindsight. There was this energy that came in for me that was like a, hey dude, sit down and get to work. And this little voice was the voice of anger who would come in and be a, it was a taskmaster for me. Sit down, do the work. And every time I wanted to go out and explore and do something fun, it was like, get back in the chair and do more work. For 20 years, this was the energy that, it, by the way, it served me. It really did serve me. But I have noticed lately that there's more for me to do as a messenger. And this is limiting. This energy had been limiting the results I could produce. There was a lid that on me. So anger got me here, but anger won't get me to where I'm going. Yeah? So here's my point. I can live my life and be positive. If you were somebody who knew me in the last 20 years, you'd say, yeah, Chris Angel, he's a positive guy. And in the background, in the shadows, there was this energy of anger that was running the show. Here's what I'm saying to you in episode 2 today. As a messenger, you have to start to look for these energies that served you, but have now become a lid on your results.